So we've talked about the definition of the cross product, as well as how to find its magnitude and its general direction using the right-hand rule. But what if we actually want to find the components of the cross product of two vectors? So let's say we have vectors u and v, and vector u has the components u1, u2, u3, or we could write it like this with the coordinate unit vectors, and then vector v is v1, v2, v3, or once again, we could write it with the coordinate unit vectors. Let's think about what the components are of u cross v. So I'm going to briefly show you the proof of how we derived the formula to do this, and then I'll show you a few different shortcut ways to actually compute the components of the cross product. So what we're going to use in this proof is actually one of the distributive properties of the cross product. So if you recall, that looks like this. And I am trying to find the cross product of these two vectors, u and v. U is u1i plus u2j plus u3k cross with v, which is v1i plus v2j plus v3k. Okay. So I'm going to use this distributive property to expand this cross product. And really what this is going to look like is what you would do if you were FOILing two trinomials, except you've got the cross products thrown in there, of course. So my first term here is going to come from multiplying these or crossing these two terms. So that's going to be u1 v1 times I cross I. And then so on down the line. So if I do all the terms, then I'm going to have plus u1 v2 times I cross j plus u1 v3 times I cross k, and then continuing plus u2 v1 j cross I plus u2 v2 j cross j plus u2 v3 j cross k plus u3 v1 k cross I plus u3 v2 k cross j, and then finally plus u3 v3 k cross k. Okay, so we're going to clean this up a little. The first thing we can realize is that I cross I, J cross J, and K cross K are all going to give us a zero vectors. So I'm going to just go ahead and cross out the three terms that have that. And then let's look at what we have left over. Now for this next step, I simply need to remember the cross products of the coordinate unit vectors. So for example, if you recall, I cross J is k. I cross k is negative j. J cross I is negative k. J cross k is I. K cross I is j. And then finally, k cross j is negative I. Okay, and finally in my last step, I'm just going to group these terms. So if you notice, I have, for example, a vector or a component in the k direction and in the negative k direction, j and negative j, I and negative I. So I'm going to group those together, keeping my positives and negatives. So if I do that, it's going to look like this. So here we see that the x component or the I component of the cross product is u2 v3 minus u3 v2. The y or j component is u3 v1 minus u1 v3, and then the k or z component is u1 v2 minus u2 v1. And this is the formula you can use to find the components of the cross product. But, of course, this formula is pretty complicated to remember. There's all these different subscripts and different combinations, And of course, you have to get the order of everything right. So it's pretty tricky to remember. So what I'm going to do is also show you a way to get to the same formula by using matrices. And you may not have ever worked with matrices before, but that's okay. You can just learn the algorithm that I'm going to show you, and it may be more helpful for you in finding the components of the cross product. So here I'm defining my vectors u and v in the same way I did before. And what I'm saying is that the cross product, u cross v, is given by the determinant of the matrix I've written here. Okay, so a matrix is simply an array of variables or numbers in rows and columns. It looks like this. And when the matrix is contained within these vertical bars, you're being asked to find the determinant of that matrix. So let's look at how this matrix is set up, and then we'll talk about how to find its determinant. So the way this matrix is set up, this U cross V matrix, is first of all, in this first row, you'll see I have the coordinate unit vectors, I, J, K. And then in the next row, I have the components of vector U, which is the first vector in your cross product, U1, U2, U3. And then in the final row, I have the components of vector V, V1, V2, V3. So you'll always set up your matrix like this if you want to use it to find the cross product. So let's out to the side just go over how to the formula for finding the determinant of a matrix, and then we'll apply it to this matrix. So here I've set up just an arbitrary 3x3 matrix, and let's look at step by step how to take its determinant. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pull out this entry or element A1. And I'm going to multiply it by the determinant of a 2x2 matrix. And that 2x2 matrix is going to be a subset of my bigger matrix here. So what is that 2x2 matrix? Well, the way you can think about this is you can think about eliminating the row and the column that A1 are in. Okay, so that would look like this. And then I look at the elements I have left. And that's the 2x2 matrix. Whose determinant I want to multiply by. Okay, so that's my first term. Now my second term, the trick here is that it's going to be minus. Okay, you got to remember that minus here. And now I'm going to pull out the term A2. And once again, I'm going to be multiplying by the determinant of a 2x2 matrix, and I'm going to find that 2x2 matrix in a similar way. I'm going to eliminate the row and the column that A2 is in, and then fill in the remaining terms in their same orientation. Okay, and then finally, I'm going to add A3. Okay, so the key here is that my signs are alternating. So plus A3. And then once again, the determinant of a 2x2 matrix. And so to find that matrix, we're going to eliminate the row and the column with A3. And then here, my leftover elements are B1, B2, C1, C2. Okay, so this is the first step in finding the determinant of a 3x3 matrix. Now to finish this out, we have to know how to define the determinant of a 2x2 matrix. That's not too tricky. So let me just make up an arbitrary 2x2 matrix. Its elements will be A, B, C, D. Okay, so the determinant of this matrix is going to be AD, okay, so this diagonal right here, minus the product of the terms in the other diagonal, so minus BC. So AD minus BC. Okay, so let's apply that to our 3x3 matrix, going off the work we have so far. So I should get A1 times a quantity, B2 C3 minus B3 C2, okay, then minus A2 times a quantity, B1 C3 minus B3 C1, and finally plus A3 times a quantity, B1, C2, minus B2, C1. And this is the determinant of my 3x3 matrix. So now that we know this process, let's apply it to the original matrix we're looking at, this matrix we set up to find the cross product of U and V. And we'll use the exact same process. Okay. So if I use the same algorithm, the first thing I'm going to be doing is pulling out this element I hat, the unit vector I, and then multiplying by a 2x2 matrix, which in this case is a matrix U2, U3, V2, V3. Then it should be minus J times the determinant of the matrix U1, U3, V1, V3, then plus K times the determinant of U1, U2, V1, V2. And then to finish out, I simply calculate the determinant of each of these 2x2 matrices. So I'm going to have I times U2, V3 minus U3, V2 minus vector J times U1, V3 minus U3, V1 plus vector K times U1, V2 minus U2, V1. Okay? And you might want to write that in a slightly different order, but this gives us the components of the cross product. Now, if you compare this to what we derived before, you'll see that they're indeed the same thing. They're written slightly different, right? Because in the formula we just found, our J term is negative, so that switches the order of the terms in the parentheses. But you can easily verify that they're the same. So you have a choice to make then. You can either just memorize the formula for finding the components of the cross product, or you can learn how to take the determinant of a 3x3 matrix, and you can do it that way. It's up to you which way you think is easier, but this is how you find the components of the cross product.